So we have a lot of clarity. We have high confidence that our Skinject patch very likely would now become commercially available sometime in 2027. So very exciting news for us.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Dr. Raza Bokhari. He is the CEO of Medicus Pharma. And Dr. Bokhari, great to see you again. How are you?
I'm doing really well, Steve. Thank you for having me back on your program.
Yeah, well, you and I have talked over the last little while about the work that you're doing on giving the FDA information they need to give you feedback on your Skinject microneedle therapy program. And sure enough, you've gotten some results back from the FDA, or at least some feedback, and it seems quite positive.
Indeed, Steve, this is an exciting day for us at Medicus Pharma, where we are advancing forward a clinical development program of a novel, non-invasive treatment to treat non-melanoma skin diseases, especially basal cell carcinoma of the skin, using these genetically designed microneedle arrays. And we came on the scene as your audience has been very supportive of us. Actually, 2 years ago today, today is our second year anniversary, where we as an investor operator believed in this asset that addresses a very large market opportunity, 7 million cases that are waiting in the queue for a treatment alternative. And surgeons, there's not enough surgeons available to do most procedure. And so the FDA gave us some feedback in a Type C meeting setting where we were seeking further alignment about with respect to the regulatory pathway we need to follow to bring this novel asset to market. And we're very pleased that the FDA agrees with us that we can use a 505(b)(2) pathway, which will permit us to leverage the existing safety data of doxorubicin. So we have a lot of clarity. We have high confidence that our Skinject patch very likely would now become commercially available sometime in 2027. So very exciting news for us.
Yeah, so they looked at, you know, study design, endpoints, patient population, all that. When you talk about this, the safety part of it, just talk to me a bit about that, because that's a key part of this, correct?
So in drug development, Steve, the mandate of the FDA primarily is safety. Whenever these new treatment modalities are going through clinical studies, efficacy is important. It alleviates and cures pain and suffering, but it is of no benefit if they cause morbidities or mortalities. So safety profile is the most important thing. And doxorubicin, as a potent chemotherapeutic agent, has been studied for 2 or 3 decades. And there is a substantial data available which you can rely on using this 505(b)(2) pathway. So the pivotal study, which usually is the biggest cost involved in drug development, which can cost up to $1 billion. And the pivotal study, which is phase three studies, is spread over thousands of patients. And the primary objective is to have safety data. In our development program, since FDA has agreed that we can rely on existing safety data for this microdosing doxorubicin, so we very likely our pivotal study won't be more than a few hundred patients, which we always have had thought and have been repeatedly saying that we could complete this development program in $50 million-$75 million from start to finish. And it seems that we would actually be able to do that now. There are still several more steps that we have to follow. Our next important meeting with the FDA is an end of phase two meeting, which we believe will happen in Q1 of next year, where the pivotal study design will get finalized. But the outlook of the company couldn't be more promising today than it ever has been.
All right, we'll leave it there, Raza. Thank you so much. Great to see you again. Congratulations on this, and we look forward to our next conversation, okay?
Thank you so much, Steve, for having me back on your program.
Dr. Raza Bokhari, the CEO of Medicus Pharma.